What the heck is that? Oh, I feel like a dang child. I feel like a dang kid in a candy store.
Mom!
Things are getting out of control, I'm getting hyped!
Oh my gosh.
Wow, yeah, this is my new toy, the snow dog. And if you're like, what the heck is a snow dog? Then you are in the exact same position I am in. I don't know anything about these other than the bare bones and what I've read last night, what I've researched last night. So if you're looking for a video of somebody that knows everything about this, or maybe a very intense technical breakdown, that's not this video. You can leave right now. But I will be going through this and explaining this and talking about this as I kind of learn how to use it right now, today, on video. So, come along. All right, full disclosure right out the gate. This is not a replacement for Pete the Polaris. I love my Polaris Sportsman so freaking much. I love my four-wheeler. I don't work for Snow Dog. I don't really know the company, but I won this Snow Dog earlier this summer. If you can freaking believe that, I won this. This is mine to keep and have. And I've basically been hiding it from you guys, not to really hide it, but it's like we didn't have snow and we didn't have ice. But now that I'm doing more research on this unit and this product and this kind of odd Russian-Canadian machine, I'm realizing it's not just a machine for winter. But yeah, we'll get into more of that later. Let me show you this. I guess give you maybe a walk around. Would that be better? Here is my snow dog. And this is going to be a crazy early ice machine in every freaking way. Yeah, if you walk around it, at first glance, it basically looks like it's kind of just the butt end of a snowmobile. From there, it looks like it kind of has lawnmower handles, like a push lawnmower or like self-propelled lawnmower, and then a sled that's attached to the back of it right here. So the motor in this boy is a Briggs & Stratton XR Professional 420cc. So it's got a good size motor in it. And I wanna say this is their standard unit. I think they make many more units that are bigger than this, and then even maybe a compact one that's smaller than this, kind of depending upon what you would do with yours. So today is legitimately the first day I've ever drove a snow dog, and I'm pretty surprised. I kind of thought I was gonna fall off it right away, especially because we don't have any snow down here and it's basically glare ice, but that's kind of why I wanted to test it too, to see if I can take it on just ice. And then obviously I'm gonna test it later this winter when there's a whole bunch of snow. But last night I was kind of doing some research and watching some videos, and I seen a bunch of guys using this like on their farms, going down different logging trails, guys using it for hunting, trapping, hard to get places that potentially my four-wheeler couldn't get to, or yeah, just crazy weird places that this thing could crawl. And I was surprised because I initially, especially with the name Snow Dog, I kind of thought it was maybe just for ice fishing, or I guess transportation in the winter, but no, I think you can use this puppy all year round. On top of it, it kind of has a heavy duty canvas type case, and from here you can get into it, and this is where you fill up your gas. You can really get in the motor if you probably take this whole sucker off. It's got a little light up front here if you're traveling probably in the evening or at night. You get in the motor from this way or unstrap it that way. It's got a lot of nice pulls around this, and I've seen some videos of dudes kind of attaching a lot of different things to these poles, racking up top, or I guess other little like holders, rod holders. You could probably even attach like the clam lock system to this, and I could put rod holders on the side of this, or maybe holders for buckets. Got a little cargo area back here. You could put maybe your Vexlo or a bunch of different goodies there, depending on what you're doing, what activity you're doing. Zip this back up. Coming around front, looking at the track looks pretty heavy duty. And when I was kind of doing a little investigating last night, the chain looks very heavy duty inside here, and the belt looks very heavy duty. So you can tell this is definitely built for the elements, especially if it kind of originated in Russia and Canada. I know these are very popular overseas, and they're just kind of hitting the US market now. My buddy told me, I think they're introduced to the US in 2018. Don't quote me on this, but that's just what I heard. And now we get to the back of this bad boy. How do you ride on it? You don't ride on the actual snow dog at all. You ride inside the sled. I've seen people trick these out, put chairs in them and stuff, but majority of people just hop in here and stand. Yeah, this thing is freaking wild. It looks like it's something out of a storybook. It looks like it's something out of a movie. And yeah, like I said before, I'm not here to tell you I love it or I hate it. Like I said, this is the first 30 minutes I've ever been with this unit, basically ever. So this is just initial reactions and a walkthrough. But I'm excited to kind of test this thing in a bunch of different elements. Something really cool that I'm very excited about this is my buddy Matt Johnson, he works at Clam, and some other guys that work at Clam who have really kind of put these to the test, say you can bring this on like 3, 4, 5 inches of ice, very little ice. So especially during early ice season, which we're in right now, I'm on like 4 inches of ice right here. That makes mobility early in the season and getting to far way back spots, doesn't matter if it's a backwater or a giant lake, what have you, that is way better than freaking walking. And you can pull all your gear behind it. We'll get to that in a sec. So on the backside of the snow dog, it's got a pretty heavy duty hitch you can see here. That's where you connect the sled. And now let's hop in it and start this sucker up. It's extremely easy to start up. You legit just stand on the sled, attach your left wrist to the kill switch, make sure the unit's turned on, put your choke all the way to the left, and then it's an electric start right here. It's on. Give it a little bit of gas. And you're going. The brake over here so you can brake. I'll shut that off. So yeah, if you've seen any of my videos in the past, you may have an inkling that I am no Olympian. I'm not extremely nimble or agile. I did play sports, but I'm kind of clumsy. If I can stand on that thing and drive it, so can my grandma. So the next thing I'm gonna put to the test is kind of simulate a situation like I'm actually going ice fishing, which I am later today, but I'm just filming this pretty close to the house. But I'm gonna kind of build it out like a train. So this thing is meant to haul gear. It's meant to haul your ice fishing gear, maybe your buddy's ice fishing gear, out to the spot, turn around, pick up your buddies, so on and so forth. We don't have to make a long walk across the lake. And especially during early ice, if we do get some snow, when you pull your ice shack, and especially you have all the gear like you normally take out, it's like, it sometimes takes hours to get to the spot you actually wanna go to. Where this, you could get there on early ice, I don't know, in minutes, so. Yeah, let's attach my toboggan and my ice shack right behind it and kind of see how this works as a train. That seemed easy enough. Okay, the train is attached and I'm gonna rip it. Maybe faster than I did before. I don't know. We're just testing things. We're doing things. That was fun. That was really fun. I don't, like I said before, I don't know like all the stats on these and I don't know what the top speed was, but I feel like I was just ripping 25 miles an hour right there on the glare ice. And to be honest, I'm pretty surprised that it even drives as well, because like I said, there's no snow and this is like, I don't know, looks like the butt end of a snowmobile. And I kind of thought I'd spin out much more. I thought kind of the train behind it would kick out much more, but it's not. So. If it's performing like this on ice, I know it'll perform even better in the snow, because that's, I feel like, what it's really meant for. All right, here's something I just figured out as well. The whole handle system here, it flips up. And originally I was like, okay, is that just for kind of compact transportation? But I think the thought process behind that is if you flip this lever here, you can now go in reverse. So I can just run the throttle or the brake right here and put this thing in reverse. So if I ever do get in a tough spot or a corner or go down a weird logging trail and I'm stuck, I can just always reverse out, which is pretty sweet. To be honest, I wouldn't think this thing would have reverse, but it definitely does. So here's where I feel like I need your guys' help. Like I said, I haven't watched a ton of videos on this and haven't seen exactly how people have tricked them out, but I need your guys' creativity. Comment down below. what should I mount to this? Should I build a rack system over top? Should I mount rod racks to this? Should I mount a little rack to hold Vexlar? Should I mount a Vexlar right to this? Should I mount an auger rack on the front? Yeah, get creative in the comments below, because I would like to do some stuff to this to kind of make this a really bad to the bone early ice machine, and even just kind of a bad to the bone little off-road machine. This thing is pretty rad, and I'm still learning about it. So I did look up some pros and cons online just because I kind of wanted to read a bunch of different reviews, and this was kind of the overall consensus. Pros: proven design, Briggs & Stratton engine, affordable, excellent flotation on soft surfaces, you can get it on very thin ice. Pulling capacity is great, you can pull a lot of weight with this. Available accessories, compact, easy transportation, yes, 100%. I could see this being very popular with hunters, trappers, people that fish way in the backwoods and you gotta go down small logging trails. I could also see this being very popular on the Great Lakes where they don't get a lot of ice. I can see it being very popular in Iowa and some southern states where they also don't get great ice and they're kind of just pond hopping or hopping on a bunch of different weird little reservoirs. I could see this being popular to a lot of different people in a lot of different areas of the ice belt that aren't so common. All right, cons. Exhaust fumes are not directed away from the operator. Mine has a little cover on it that looks like you can even unscrew it and kind of shoot where you want to shoot the exhaust. They can be tippy, I could totally see that. For the toughest turning conditions, the compact model will be more nimble than the standard. I could see that, just a smaller unit could be more nimble. Bottom line, a truly new and versatile addition to the off-road market, reliable, simple, and ready to use year-round. That's the coolest thing, you can use this thing year-round. And that's why, like, I don't know, in the past I've never really pulled the trigger on a snowmobile, because some years you get a lot of snow and you can use your snowmobile and they're freaking super fun to ride, and then other years you get no snow and it's like it just sits around. So I love my four-wheeler, I love Pete the Polaris, and I think I'm gonna find a bunch of cool new ways to use the snow dog. So yeah, comment down below ways I could trick it out. If you have questions, do not ask me. Like I said, this is my first day with the unit. Throughout this winter, I'll kind of give updates and different reviews after I've used it in like a foot of snow or different conditions, and then kind of my thoughts on it after a full year of use with it, or a full winter. So that's the snow dog. That's kind of a very light rundown on what I know so far, and I'm excited. So thank you so much for watching this video all the way to the end. For now, I'm gonna pack up the snow dog, all my ice gear, meet up with my pals, and make a long train as we go across this lake in the hopes to catch some freaking slabs. So I appreciate it. Thank you so much. And I guess there's nothing left to be said than stay tuned. And as always, let the adventure begin. See you. Oh my pretty babe, something ain't right. Got to find a way to move ahead. Oh my pretty baby.